5.5 days of scintillating student action here at the Shuang Lao Sports Centre Stadium. There is just one evening's entertainment yet to go here on the athletics track. So the men are out for the 800 metres. We have finalists from Switzerland, France, Algeria, Germany, Australia and Poland. Third round of the week for these men. Some have run more because of the 15. We're off again. It was a little bit unsteady again there from the Frenchman Leclesio in the silver hair, but they have got away this time around. So around the bend in lanes before they break coming into the back straight. There were three PBs set in the top eight, but two of those men didn't get through, including Ma Zhongqiang and the third Frenchman. So off they go at the moment. It's the Polish favourite, perhaps, who is leading them at the moment, Wajdecka. Went to the European Junior Championships earlier this year, the under-23s, that is, in the 1500 metres, and was eighth in the final on that occasion. The man who goes to the Academy of Physical Education in Katowice, and they reached the bell in 56 seconds. So relatively pedestrian. It is still raining. It was a huge thunderstorm earlier in the day, and it's the Australian Jack Lunn who's taken over at the front. However, Wajdecka not too happy to see that happen, and he goes striding down the back straight once more. In third place is Sherad, the silver medalist from the 1500 metres, looking for a second medal. He's though been overtaken. The two Algerians together. Lund looks like he's just struggling a bit, but out front it's Maciej Wajdecka who is leading at the moment. He brings them into the home straight. He's got a couple of metres on everybody else. They will try to come back at him. He's beginning just to tie up a little bit, but so is everybody else. Will he make it to the line? It's going to be gold for Poland, silver for France. Leclesio with a fine finish. But it's gold to Maciej Wajdecka, and celebrations for the Academy of Physical Education, Katowice. Well, Leclesio, you'd have to say, left that a little bit late, perhaps. Cross the line in 1:49. He's run 2 seconds faster than that in his career, but Leclesio with his silver hair, well, maybe it was a premonition after all. Second place for the Frenchman, who goes to the University Cité Paris Cité, which is right down in the south of the city, and it's the place where the athletes were staying during the 2003 World Championships. Well, we'll need a photo finish for the third place. The two Algerians throwing themselves at the line, both thinking that one of them was going to get the silver. So then, which of the two Algerians has got that as the Frenchman comes flying past? Oh, it's so close. So close. So then, Poland's fifth gold medal of the week then. Leclesio second, and a shared Algerian bronze medal. We said it was close, and they could not be split even on thousands. The women are out for the 1500 metres final this year. Everybody trying to inherit the title from Katharina Grantz of Germany, who beat Georgia Griffiths of Australia, and Courtney Husmith of Canada last time out. Three and three quarter laps of this rather wet track here inside the Shuang Lao Centre Stadium. So then it's Pelikor who's gone off fastest. It was Lizakowska who was the fastest in the semi-finals. Asira of Uganda right behind her. Uganda have won this title in the past with Dorcas Azhok in 2015 in South Korea. And she looked good the other night. Big improvement for her in the last 4 years after She was only 11th in the 5,000 metres and didn't finish the 10,000 metres at the World University Games in Italy in 2019. So then Pellacoro bringing them round to cross the line for the first time. Exactly three laps to go. Well, there is another pole in this race as well, Alexander Pozinski. She's 23 years old from the Warsaw University of Life Sciences. The Japanese is Saki Katagihara. First major championships to her for the women from the University of Tsukuba. Nothing's really lit up yet. Pellacoro is leading, but it's nominally so. Nobody has really lit the touch paper as yet. And in fact, if anything, they're getting even slower. So then everybody in it at the moment. The one South African who is in it is at the back. You can see Sian Svart, bronze medalist in the 800 metres. She's got a 4.15, broke 4.16 for the first time this year from the University of Pretoria. And, well, at this stage, at this pace, there's no need to really get going. A little bit of a trip, perhaps, there from Sian Alyadiz of Turkey. Four national titles for the 23-year-old who runs for the University of South Carolina, Columbia, including the 1500 title for Turkey this year. Pellacoro still leading. First sign of one of the French women coming to the fore. That is Sarah Madeleine, 24 years old, who goes to INSA in Lyon, down there in the Rhone Valley. Still pretty slow. It's going to be a tear-up. Round the outside comes the Turk. They're now moving out. They're trying to get in the right position. Those who are on the curb on the inside are not really very well placed. 600 metres to go. Still no clearer to what is going to happen in this race. Pellacoro still leading. She has done all the way through. I like the look of Asiro there, the Ugandan. She's well placed and just moving out of the shoulder of Alyandiz. To see her wearing the glasses. Round the back, Kitagara now decides that she needs to be a little bit nearer the front. As they come to the bell, they are all vying for places. Pellacoro for the first time goes behind. And it's the Luxembourger Vera Hoffmann who hits the front. Her third World University Games, the national champion at 1500 metres indoors and out. Her 14 national titles. This is her third World University Games after appearances in 2017 and 2019. Can she be inspired by the victory of her teammate in the 100 metres the other night? Pellacoro is not out of this yet, though. She has now taken the place on the shoulder of the Luxembourger. It's between these two, it looks like, at the moment. They are stretched out. It was a burnout. It didn't really light up until they got past the bell, and Pellacoro goes back in front. Hoffman, has she got anything left? The woman from the Saarland University tried to come down the outside, but Pellacoro is moving forward. Pellacoro going in front, and Italy are going to take the title. Gold for Pellacoro. Double gold for the Italian in her first major championships. And the 800 metres winner wins the 1500 as well. Silver for the Luxembourger Vera Hoffmann. Didn't make it out of the heats in 2017. Seventh in the final 2 years later. It's Pellacoro, though, who is the champion. So then the official confirmation then of Laura Pellacoro winning ahead of Vera Hoffmann and Sian Alyadiz. That is the podium for the women's 1500 metres.
And in the field events this evening, we have the men's javelin throw finals. And there's the list of the top eight there. And there will be 12 in this, going down to Kim of Korea, who will be the last to throw in this event. Leini of Finland lining up for his third round throw. He's fast, but he's a bit out of control sometimes, and we don't know whether he's going to throw 60 or 80. But here he goes. Oh, he stood up on that one. Good block. Yep, there you go. That could take the lead for the Finnish boy. Pats his chest. And he's pleased with that one. You could see there was control on the delivery. Took that one step, two step stop after that final left foot block. He puts his arms up. 78-42 for the Finn. And lining up in the javelin, the pole, Polish thrower, Cyprian Merzyglud. Now he's got a best this season of 82.04. So he's got a bit of quality. What can he do in this? The rain has stopped. Oh, he stands up nicely on that one. Oh, and it's the first throw over 80 metres. It's just crept over 80 metres. Now, in the fourth round, he went 78-16. And look at that. Nice, tall platform. Finishes over the top. Great flight on that javelin. Comes down to ground. Sticks in. And he's the first thrower tonight. I think it'll be over 8. So, in the fifth round, he goes into gold medal position with 80.02. Now, Matu Servisius, defending champion from Naples. What can he do? Oh, look at that. He responds in the fifth round. We've been waiting all night for 80-metre throws, and then you get two, a bit like the number 10 bus in London. You don't get one for ages, and then two come along at the same time. So, the defending champion looks like he might have snatched back that gold medal as they go into the final round. Look at that, 80-37, he goes first. What can Suzuki do? 75-92 in that fourth round. He's been throwing consistently around that sort of distance all night. Here he is in his sixth attempt. Oh, and it's his best throw of the evening. But I don't think he's going to threaten the medals, is he? Wow. Stranger things have happened. This javelin has certainly come to life in this fifth and sixth round. Bit of fist pumping going on. 78-41, and look at that, he just finishes in fourth position. Great throwing from the Japanese thrower. But the man who takes gold, he defends his championship performance from Naples in 2019. And Edis Matu Servisius takes gold again, 80-37. He pips the pole at the post and takes the gold out of this man's clutches. He went 80.02 on the fifth round throw. What a great competition it turned into in the end. So Matu Servisius, 80.37, takes gold. Merzyglud of Poland takes silver. And in bronze, Mazesh, the man who led for quite a lot of the competition, Lerni from Finland, takes bronze. So, men's long jump, there's the 12 jumpers in the long jump final. Shang of China, second attempt on the runway. That's a good jump. I think that could be enough to put him up in the medal positions, having jumped 7.44. I get the fist pump, so he knows something that I don't know just yet. But yeah, you can see those feet landing around the 8-metre line on that graphic on the pit. But of course, that's not marked on the sand. That's just for our benefit to see how far they're jumping so we get a rough idea. Oh, and 7.83 goes into the lead into a minus 0.7 meters per second wind. We have Xu lining up for his third jump. They make the cut after three rounds. That's a good jump for the Chinese in the third round. And he gets the white flag, does he? Yep, he looks like he's safe on. Yes, he's safe on the board. So Xu in his third round. That's going to start to encroach on the leaders in this long jump competition. It's been sort of idling along in the rain, but the rain has cleared now, and we're now clear. Run 7.82 jumps into silver medal position. Zhang from China in the long jump lining up for his fourth round jump. Good takeoff. Oh, no, that's close to 8 meters. That's close to surely an improvement on 7.82, 83 that he jumped in on his second jump. Much more height. Out of control. He's twisting in the air. Good on the board with that takeoff foot. Drives up off that board. Rotates a little bit as he comes down to land. But I think that's, yep, 7.93, and the wind has changed around a little bit, so he's got a tad of assistance. Lin in the long jump. Last attempt for the Chinese Tapai long jumper. And great height. Bit untidy in his hitch kick, but he gets himself out there into the pit. And Lin of Chinese Taipei is looking at that. Oh, look, 7.83, and he goes into silver medal position. Wen of Chinese Taipei coming in for his final jump of the competition. Best of 7.65, out of the medals. What can he do? Great jump by the Chinese Taipei athlete. And look, he's on his toes. He's saying, no, I haven't won, have I? No, he could, well, 7.90 needed. 7.93 leads it. His teammate has just gone 7.83 to put himself in the medal positions. This guy's outside it. China were 1 and 2 coming into this last round. Look, they're having a very, very close look at this. So, Wen of China. Oh, look, 7.83, and with count back, 7.65 in the first round. He goes into silver medal, and his teammate goes into third. So, Lin now in bronze. Then in silver, and Zhang of China takes gold with 7.93. Wow, what a competition that was. 7.93, season's best for Zhang of China. And then Wen in the silver medal position from Chinese Taipei, and Lin following home in the bronze medal position. So Chinese Taipei take 2 medals. China take gold, though, with Wang's 7.93. We've got the women's high jump, and here's a list of the competitors. 12 high jumpers in this final. Pulkkinen now. We go and move on to her personal best at 188 set this year. First attempt, 188. Oh, and that's a great clearance by the Finn. She's pretty pleased with that. One a relief on her face at 184, third attempt to stay in, and then she goes clear. So this Kulichenko of Cyprus, who is collecting zeros and getting over first attempts throughout this competition. Now we're getting up to the serious end, and there you go, clear up to 188. 2 failures, but then she goes clear at 188, the Cypriot. Yeboah from Ghana has those two-time failures at 188. Oh, it looks untidy, but she's over and she celebrates. So third-time clearance for Yeboah. And this height of 188 is starting to sort them out as they get to the higher reaches in the high jump final for women. Yeboah of Ghana Second time attempt. Second attempt at 1 meter 91. Oh, she's gone clear. Oh, look at the celebrations for her. 191. And that, I think, is probably a new personal best for the Ghanaian. Yep. Kulichenko of Cyprus. Oh, she goes clear too. So we have two clearances at 1 meter 91. Now her best is 191, so that's an equal personal best for her. The other athlete left in at this stage at 191 is Polkkonen, who equaled her personal, set a personal best of 188 at that last height. So her last attempt at 190. Oh, and that's a good attempt by the Finnish athlete. But she goes out at 191 after that first time clearance at 188. Kulichenko now in the women's high jump. Oh, and she just clips it off with her heels. Desperately disappointing for the Cypriot. Just a mere touch on that bar as she goes over and then just catches it with her heels. That's her third failure at 194, the Cypriot athlete. But she cleared 191, and Yeboa of Ghana now has the opportunity to go over 191. No, sorry, 194. She's had two failures. Oh, and she goes clear. Oh. Celebration time. She doesn't quite know what to do. Two athletes left at this height. Arm swing up. Great height gained off that takeoff foot. And she curls her back over the bar and her feet follow. And she's tying up the loose strands of that long hair so that it doesn't knock the bar off. So you can see there that Yeboah goes clear on a third attempt at 1 meters 94. She takes gold. The 22-year-old from Ghana, Rose Yeboah, studying at the University of Cape Coast in Ghana. Second goes to Kulichenko of Cyprus, and the Finn Polkkonen takes bronze with 1 meter 88. But Rose Yeboah takes gold for Ghana.